before, I actually felt a little discouraged just because I'm an engineer. You know, engineering isn't a very easy subject. So, you know, I was thinking, you know, should I drop this class? What am I going to do? Things are getting hectic. And I came here, you know, start to kind of get a little more confidence. And
you could want all you want. You could want more money. You could want more success. You could want a better life for you and your family. You could want the finest things in life. But unless you get off your ante, nothing's really going to happen. True or false? See, it was.
Considero de que la charla estuvo super buena. Me gustó mucho porque son cosas que hasta cierto punto creo que sabemos, pero que necesitamos estar que nos recuerden de ellas constantemente.
Your lecture was very intellectual and you kept the audience involved.
16. I got here without money in my pocket, without knowing a word of English, without my parents. I was even homeless for a while. About 3 years.
Yeah, I felt a little nervous before because I was the only person, but now I feel motivated and like I can do something.
I was one of them. Our goal, escaping from Cuba.
I think through my years through college, I kind of lost motivation, but just realizing that it's still within me, it's easier to actually grasp it when you're here rather than just kind of try to find it yourself.
So. Forward through the bay, we hear a voice. Turn back or you will suffer the consequences.
I came in here with a little sadness, and then I heard your inspiration and it motivated me to wake up every day and do a little more of my life.
No, realmente yo venía acá con la esperanza de aprender algo y realmente lo cumplí. Todo lo que dijo realmente es lo que me está pasando a mí y sinceramente tengo que aprender a decírmelo de que sí puedo sin importar lo que las personas me digan que no puedo hacerlo. Entonces me encantó.
We knew exactly what the consequences were back in 1994 for trying to escape. There were three. Number one, you could get killed. Number two, you might drown. And number three, you might get life in prison. All this wanting something better. All this wanting to go and pursue our dreams. All this wanting what some people refer to as freedom.
Okay, my name is Juan Carlos Ramirez. I am from Mexico, and this is the first time that I see the Cuban Gog, and it was an amazing experience. It was very positive, and it was very focusing. Yeah.
Seconds later, sirens went off. They were coming from all directions. They're coming from the right, from the left, from the front, from the back, from the bottom, from the top. It sounded like 300 fire trucks wailing the sirens all at once. See, back in our boat, we were scared. Actually, scared is an understatement. We were petrified. Some people were screaming and yelling. Some people were crying. Some people were on the knees praying, Dios mío, por favor. Some people wanted to jump off the boat. Some people wanted to stop the boat. Some people wanted to turn back the boat. In the midst of all this, the captain of our boat steps forward. He paces back and forth, looks straight into the eyes of the ladies, the men, the elderly, the teenagers. There is silence among those 30 people. Then and only then, he said, if you think that moving forward, now that the going got tough, if you think that moving forward, now that you feel intimidated, if you think that moving forward in the midst of all this is going to be painful, try turning back.
During it was like it was interesting and made me look back at certain moments in my life that are related to yours, and after it made me think about more I could do to improve myself.
We had a challenge that early morning, and the question we ask people all around the country, all around the world is, who doesn't? For instance, you go and pursue your dreams, goals, and things you want, you know that the going might get tough. True or false? You know that sometimes things just might not work out exactly as you plan. You know that sometimes you might get confused, dejected, demotivated, frustrated, heartbroken. For instance, it is at that point when a lot of people think about quitting. It is at that point when a lot of people think about giving up. It is at that point when a lot of people think about turning back. It is also at that point, if you ever find yourself in that position, when things are just not working out, when you feel like you just want to give up, when you feel like you just want to turn back, it is at that point that I encourage you to ask yourself, what's going to be more painful? Moving forward or turning back.
Good job. You actually inspired me to, you know, just take on whatever that comes my way. So I just want to say thank you.
Was nothing but an awful song.